Welcome to Filmora Pro, a new way to power up your storytelling. Today we'll be giving you a few more tips and tricks on animating objects by adjusting the anchor point, as well as copying, offsetting, and stretching out your keyframes. Just like before, you can jump ahead to a specific topic with timestamps down in the description. We did an introduction to keyframing in Animation 101, where we covered how to work with keyframes, the graph editor, how to add motion blur to your shots, and how to make 3D looking animations. Before watching this tutorial, you should definitely check that one out first. In Filmora Pro, we can adjust the object's position by using the position attribute in the controls panel, but we can also move objects by adjusting the anchor point value. The main difference with using the anchor point value is that it moves your object independently of this anchor point we can see here in the viewer panel. You can get some really cool rotational motion from this. For example, if we don't change our anchor point and just adjust our object's rotation, it will simply spin. But if we move the anchor point outside of the object and we make the same adjustment to the rotation, we'll see that the object orbits the anchor point instead, giving us a completely new kind of motion. Another cool thing we can do with anchor point is adjust where the scaling of an object comes from. For example, I've got this speech bubble PNG image that bounces into frame. It would look a lot better if it scaled from the bottom right so that it looked more like it was coming out of this gentleman's phone. We can do this by adjusting our anchor point to line up with the bottom right corner, and then reposition our bubble to where it should be placed. Going back to rotational motion, let's use anchor point adjustments to make something really cool from scratch, like a simple clock animation. What we'll want to do is go to New Plane to create a plane, doesn't really matter what size it is, and we'll color it white. Next, let's drag our plane onto the timeline and lengthen its duration a bit. And we'll adjust its shape in the viewer panel to make it a vertical rectangle like this. Next, let's go to our rectangle's anchor point value and adjust the Y value, which is the second value, the one on the right, so that our anchor point is close to the bottom of the rectangle. This will be our minute hand. To animate this, let's click the Display Timeline button up here if it's not already selected, and we'll set a couple rotation keyframes. Let's move our playhead to the beginning and enable rotation keyframing by pressing this circle by rotation. And then we'll jump ahead by setting our time code to 1 minute. And finally, we'll set a second rotation keyframe by going to our wheel beside rotation and spinning it around once, or by entering 1 by the X. Now we'll have a slow rotational motion. Next, let's duplicate the plane by copying it, right-clicking the track above, and selecting Paste, which will paste the new plane on this layer. This will be our second hand. Let's drop a fill color effect onto our clip and make the shape a nice deep red, and make sure that the blend amount is set to 100%. Let's go to our viewer panel and adjust the shape a bit to make it a little narrower than our minute hand. Next, let's go to our rotation. Let's jump ahead to the final keyframe by pressing period on our keyboard and change our 1x to 60x. This means instead of rotating once, our second hand will rotate 60 times. Let's take a look at that. Looks pretty good. Let's finish this up by going to our second hand's clip properties and turning on motion blur. You may only see your motion blur if your playback quality is set to final. When working with complex animations, it's useful to be able to copy them to different layers. I've got this plane that slides in and spins here, which I animated by setting a couple rotation keyframes and by easing a few position keyframes in the graph editor. Here's what it looks like. Let's say we want to make this a fancy title card by adding text on top of this plane and having it match the movement of this plane. First, let's click the text icon at the bottom left of our viewer panel. I'll type in Filmora Pro, go to our text panel, and make sure the font is about the right size. Let's also adjust our text clip to be the same duration as the plane below. So if we leave this the way it is, the text is not going to be moving with our shape. We'll need to copy the purple square's position keyframes onto the text if we want our text to move with it. So let's highlight our shape's position keyframes and copy them. Then we'll go to our text clip, select position, and paste the keyframes. Our text will be off-center due to the anchor point being set to the bottom left of our text. We can correct that by adjusting our text's anchor point and recentering it. Now we've got a text animation that moves with the plane behind it. Finally, we can offset our text's animation easily by highlighting all of our keyframes and moving them a small amount of frames forward or back to make it look like the text is leading or following the shape. Sometimes when fine-tuning your animations, you'll want to adjust their timing. Timing is the amount of frames between each of your keyframes, which is easy to adjust in Filmora Pro's effects panel. However, when your animation has a large number of keyframes, sometimes you might want to slow down the entire animation in general. This can be tricky to do keyframe by keyframe, but there's a better way we can do this. First, let's go to the plane on the bottom track and increase the length of our clip. Next, let's move our playhead to the first keyframe. One way we can do this is by selecting one of our animated attributes, like rotation, and hit the comma key to go back to the previous keyframe. Next, let's highlight all of our keyframes, and while holding Alt on Windows or Option on Mac, drag one of our keyframes on the far right and drag them further to the right. As you can see, this will stretch out all of our keyframes and as a result slow down our entire animation. Let's do the same for our text. And there we go. We've easily slowed down our animation. So that's a look at how you can adjust an object's anchor point, as well as how you can copy, paste, offset, and change the speed of your animations. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more tutorials on how you can take your editing to the next level. There's no limit to what you can make.